a lonesome away from your kindred and all by the campfire at night.
When you think of country music in Australia, you think of Slim Dusty. And his Pub With No Beer has become an unofficial anthem.
You've always written songs, but your greatest hit of all was one that you didn't write, The Pub With No Beer.
That's right, yeah. I wish I had written it, but it's just one of those songs. It was recorded as a B-side. I wrote the A-side, as I called it, one called Saddle Boy, which was very successful, but of course the old pub.
While its success came as a bit of a surprise, to Slim there was a reason it took off.
The pub was released today. You know, social drinking is such a way of our life today, but it was released in the middle of the rock era when Presley was raging and Bill Haley. It was so different. And then, of course, as I say, we're a pretty good beer-drinking country.
What people didn't know at the time was there was, in fact, a lost verse in the song, and it was remembered by its writer, Gordon Parsons, and singer, Chad Morgan.
Gordon did the composing, but Chad wrote all the things stuck down, you see. So through writing it down, he remembered it. And Gordon forgot the verse, and I don't know why, I never used the other verse. And so last year when Chad was with us, he said, remember there was another verse to that song? So I said, yeah, there was. Chad remembered it.
It's a long straight road and the engine is deep.
Slim Dusty is a giant of the industry and some still consider him Australia's unchallenged king of country. He was also David Gordon Kirkpatrick.
Your wife didn't even know your real name at the day that you were engaged.
That's right, yeah. She was quite embarrassed when the wedding date was set, and then her mother asked, well, what's his real name? And Joy just didn't know. I'm two people, I suppose, in business-wise, with Joy and myself. It's, you know, it's Kirkpatrick, but...
Yes, your real name is...
It's Gordon, and it's a very foreign name to me now. So, you know, once I've got the guitar and I'm on the road and meeting people and working, I'm just not... the Gordon Kirkpatrick. There's no way, I can't even feel that way. I'm Slim Dusty.
Slim was just a boy when that name was born.
How long ago did you shed the name Gordon Kirkpatrick?
I was quite young, I was about 11.
So how did you settle on the name Slim Dusty?
Well, we had so many cowboy names around, like Buddy and Tex and Wilf Carter, people like that. So I thought of the name Slim first, and then I felt I needed something Australian to go with it. So it was Dusty, because we've got a dusty country, brown country. I started to write songs when I was about 10 or 11. Right from the beginning, I started to think about, well, if I'm going to write, I must write about Australia.
I love to have a beer with Duncan. I love to have a beer with Duncan.
Slim wasn't the only one in his family with music in his veins.
Dad used to teach me these old parodies. He played the old-time fiddle. He'd lay the fiddle down his arm and sing with the fiddle. So that's the first thing I played. I grabbed Dad's fiddle and I marked, scratched marks down the neck of the fiddle to take the place of frets. And I strummed that for a short time. Made a mess of Dad's fiddle.
We're just a traveling country band.
Slim's family, including wife Joy and their kids, Anne and David, were some of the busiest in the biz.
Joy and I have just had 7.5 weeks away on a holiday, and that's been all travel, up to Queensland, up to the Northern Territory, out to an Aboriginal cattle station, and moving all the time. So the kids reckon we're travel junkies, but we just like travelling and meeting people. We're very much a family thing. Anne is joining us for the national tour, so is David. Once we finish the national tour, I'm supposed to do another record before Christmas. There'll be some more country tours, and then we're planning a very big concert at Tamworth for the award weekend. And then the kids are going overseas next year, and they're trying to drag Joy and I over with them. But as we always say, we've got too much to do here. But there's lots happening, and it's still, I'm still very excited about recording. That's been my main interest always.
I was raised on a farm where our lives were calm in a land of honey and cream.
Slim released more than 100 albums, sold more than 7 million records, and earned more than 70 gold and platinum album certifications. But not many know how close he came to losing that precious voice.
I had this operation on the throat, and that upset the balance for a while. So to help me out, I had these voice lessons. And
how did you get into that situation then? Who did you find to teach you?
Oh, well, I was advised to go and see a particular singing teacher. He was a very nice man. And, you know, if I'm if I'm tired now or working hard, I still fall back on his technique, which is very, very handy. I think if you feel as if you're working hard and you're straining, it's not so much for country singers, but for anyone, really. I mean, if you feel that you are pushing yourself, well, it really can help you.
Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda.
As the 80s approached, Slim was sure that country music would continue to live on.
You know, everybody, there's been such a migration to the city. Country life to Central Dollar people now is quite foreign, because we find that working in the city in the clubs or doing the opera house or working anywhere, it makes no difference if they're a country music band. They're just as keen as, if, and they're like, no matter where you are. I might do the new verse of the pub if you like.
I'd like to hear it.
Oh, it's hard to believe that there's customers still, but the money's still tinkling in the old ancient till. The wine dots are happy, and I know they're sincere when they say they don't care if the pub's got no beer.
That was just fantastic. A big thanks to Rod McNeil, Bob Fitzgerald and producer Brian Hall for that. Also, to help celebrate Father's Day this year, a compilation of Slim's fishing songs has been gathered for the ultimate Gone Fishing album. Gone Fishing is available today across all streaming and download platforms, and for a limited time on CD.